So we were talking about passion earlier. What does passion mean to you, and how does it apply to your life?
Well, I think I'm very driven by passion. I think it's, you know, passion is something that really inspires you and something that inspires you over the long haul as well. So, I mean, there can be sort of fleeting passions, but if you, I think the more you know yourself, the more you understand what's going to push you and make you do stuff. And then you can sort of be a little more analytical or thoughtful about your passion and sort of put stuff together that is going to make it work.
So you've been passionate about classical singing since you were 14.
Yeah, since I was a kid. I was passionate about this one particular repertoire specifically, right. And I didn't, you know, it took me a long time to get it together, honestly. You know, even to the extent, and I could have a lot more together than I do.
Right.
But, you know, you're always, it's always a work in progress as a person, right? So I think you just, you know, you figure out what you're doing, you work on it, and over time it comes together and people say, oh, you're so together, and you say, what? No, I'm so not. There's a million things.
It's a million different little pieces that make a big picture, right?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
You know, your big picture must look good.
Yeah, well, you know, you just, I think the secret of passion is to look at people who are slightly better than you are and not get too caught up in people who are, you know, a million times better, and you think, oh my God, they're so great, I'll never be there.
Right.
Or
you defeat yourself before you even get started by doing that.
Yeah, or people that you've got some kind of jealousy for, like I think that
wanting that somebody else has,
I see,
instead
a lot
of wanting for yourself.
I think anytime you find yourself wanting to put somebody down who you really don't know, like that's usually a hint that they've got something that you really want in your soul, right? You know,
maybe it's time for some inner
time for some inner work, right?
Yeah.
And figure out, you know, well, okay, if I was working towards that, would I feel better about myself? Because I don't think it's actually getting it that is going to make you feel better. Like it's not. I mean, like, you know, say you really wanted a Mercedes. You know, I think working towards that, you know, I'm using Mercedes as a ridiculous, you know, really concrete image.
Yeah.
But, you know, if you really, I think, you know, doing the work that's going to start you along that path is what's going to make you feel better. I don't think it's actually getting, you know, the Mercedes with the big gift bow on top. I think that's not the... That's not the thing. So
it's like if, you know, looking at, not to say I'm jealous of, but no, if I look at, like, you know, I watch old movies and I look like a Buddhist monk and you're so serene and peaceful. I'd love to be that way all the time, but, you know, the journey, I'm going on a journey to get there, right?
Yeah,
so I'm feeling good about my journey. So like, absolutely.
Yeah, and I think the phrase, you know, never compare your day-to-day life to somebody else's highlights reel.
That's so good. That's awesome.
Yeah, because we all have to live through our lives, right? And then we see, you know, somebody's, you know, social media feed, their Instagram, with all their perfect little moments, we could make up perfect little moments too, but that's...
You never know what that person is going through, how that person's life really is, right?
Yeah,
so
right.
Don't
really
focus on what you can control.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So,
okay.